Adventures of Ozzie and Harriet, starring the entire Nelson family. Here's Ozzie. Here's Harriet. Here's David. Here's Rick. And also starring in tonight's episode, here's Kris.
Hey, Rick, wait a second.
Hi, Wally.
Do you always run all the way across the campus?
What are you talking about?
Well, you must be out of shape.
Are you kidding? I got nothing but shape. Say, speaking of shape, I have this friend who's lost a lot of weight lately. He's looking very anemic and feeling very flat.
Don't tell me. Let me guess. It's your wallet and he needs how much?
Anything you can spare. I'm desperate.
Gee, I don't know. It must be catching. I'm a little flat in the wallet department myself.
Oh, that's no fair. You heard me wheezing up behind you and hit it someplace.
No, honest, I just haven't got it. I'd like to help you out, but I have to meet Kris and I'm a little late now.
Well, that's okay. It wasn't important anyway. Oh, hiya, Rich, old buddy. How's everything going?
Sorry, Wally. I'm broke.
Oh, darn it. George!
Rick!
Oh, hi, Pam.
Oh, gee, I'm glad I ran into you. Can I borrow your history notes?
Oh, that's right. You were playing a little hooky yesterday, weren't you?
Shh. Actually, I was helping my aunt out. She just opened a little tea room downtown, and I've been filling in as hostess until she can get somebody else.
Oh, I'd kind of like to have them back late this afternoon, though. I got to look them over for the quiz tomorrow.
Oh, well, maybe I better not take them then. I'll be at the tea room all afternoon and this evening, too.
Oh, well, that's no problem. I'll be working down at the law office this afternoon. I can stop by and pick them up later.
Well, gee, that'd be great if you don't mind. I'll be at the Colonial Tea Room, and it's on 4th Street, and that's in the 800 block.
Oh, well, that's right around the corner from the law office. Here you are.
Gee, I sure appreciate this.
Oh, that's okay. Gee, I better hurry. I was supposed to meet Kris about 10 minutes ago. I'll see you later.
Okay.
Oh, pardon me. Are you a friend of Rick's?
Yeah.
Oh, well, a friend of his is in desperate need of... Oh, I mean, you wouldn't want a loan. I don't suppose you could spare... No, never mind.
Oh, here you are, on this side of the bulletin board.
Never mind, I've walked around this bulletin board 100 times. You're 10 minutes late.
Gee, I'm sorry. I was a little late getting out of class, and Wally hung me up trying to borrow some money. I got over here as soon as I could.
Rick.
Oh, hi, Pam.
Hi.
Have you met my wife?
I don't believe so.
Pam Kimball? This is my wife?
Kris.
Kris? Pam's in my early European history class.
Rick, I noticed some legal-looking papers in with your notes, and I thought you might need them.
Oh, yeah, thanks. I must have left them in there by mistake.
Rick just loaned me some lecture notes for a quiz tomorrow. I hope I didn't make them too late.
Oh, no, that's okay.
Pam was just telling me about her aunt's new tea room. The Colonial Tea Room?
Yeah, you ought to come by for lunch sometime. It's right around the corner from Rick's office.
I'll do that.
Yeah, I just found out about that myself today. A little while ago.
Well, thanks again, Rick. And it was nice meeting you, Kris.
Same here.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Okay, let's run over it once again, shall we?
What?
You said you were late getting out of class, and you said you stopped to talk to Wally. But you forgot to tell me you stopped to talk to Pam.
Well, I didn't forget to tell you. I had no intention of telling you.
You didn't?
Of course not. I figured what you didn't know wouldn't make you insanely jealous.
Well, what makes you think I'm jealous? And when was she in your office?
She's never been to our office.
She seems to know where it is.
Well, I probably mentioned it to her. After all, I sit right next to her in class.
You never mentioned that before.
You're putting me on, of course.
You hope.
Come on, I'll take you to lunch.
No, I don't think I'll have time now. I talked to your mom, and she wants to go shopping this afternoon. I told her I'd go with her.
Oh, gee, I'm sorry. I hope I didn't make you miss your lunch.
Oh, no, that's okay. It's probably a good idea if I miss a couple of lunches. With all that shapely competition strolling around.
Come on, now.
Well, she is awfully pretty. You don't have to sit next to her, do you? I mean, you could move your seat, couldn't you?
Are you kidding? I had to bribe a guy $5 to get where I am. Hi.
Well, hi, Rick. Well, what do you think of them?
Oh, they're beautiful.
You didn't know I had talent, did you?
How did you make these?
Oh, no, but I put the frosting on them.
Good for you. Is there an anniversary party here tonight?
Well, there might be, and we always keep a couple birthday and anniversary cakes on hand just in case.
Well, suppose it's nobody's anniversary.
Oh, well, when it gets kind of late, we smooth the icing over, and we take the cake and we cut it up in little pieces, and we give it a French name.
Hey, that's a good idea.
Oh, listen, I'm almost finished with your notes. I'll just be a few more minutes.
Well, look, I could come back later.
Oh, no, I've got them right over here in the booth.
It's a beautiful place.
Thank you.
How long have you been open?
Just a couple weeks. We opened November the 1st. Sit down and make yourself comfortable.
Look, what an don't I come back later? I said you could have until this afternoon.
No, that's okay. I'm almost finished. Now, you sit down, and I'll get you a chocolate parfait while you're waiting, and it'll be on the house, because you were so nice.
Well, you don't have to do that.
Well, don't be silly. I want to, and I'll be right back.
Pam?
Now, don't argue. I insist.
But there's just one thing. Could you make that strawberry?
Coming right up. Now, don't you go away. Oh, here it is.
Oh, it's darling.
Yeah, it is, isn't it?
How'd you find out about it?
From a girlfriend of Rick's.
A girlfriend?
Oh, what I mean is she's a friend that happens to be a girl.
Oh, I see.
Actually, I don't think she's even a friend. He's never mentioned her before. Before today, that is.
That's right. Don't explain. Just try and remember. They're innocent till they're proved guilty.
Rick?
Oh, hi, Kris. Hi, Mom.
Hi, dear.
I just stopped by to pick up some notes from Pam. You remember her. You met her this morning.
Oh, was she the blonde with a real good figure?
Yeah, that's the one.
You noticed it, too.
Well, yeah, she sits right next to me in class. Well, that's where I met her.
What's that on your shirt?
Oh, well, that's strawberry parfait. She hadn't finished copying the notes, so I had a strawberry parfait while I was waiting. I guess it kind of looks like lipstick, huh?
Well, now that you mention it, yes.
Well, there are a lot of people in there. Well, not really, actually. There are only a few people in there. It's a nice place. It just opened a couple of weeks ago. November 1st. Hey, I have a great idea. Why don't I take you out to dinner tonight?
Does he always keep everything from you like this?
Only when a good-looking girl is involved.
Well, how about dinner?
Oh, thanks, but I've got a sorority meeting tonight, so we better eat dinner at home. I'd like to take a rain check on that, though.
Okay.
And you get an A-plus for trying.
Come on, Mom, I'll treat you to one of those strawberry parfaits.
Okay, bye, dear.
Bye.
Bye. Mom, would you mind picking up my notes for me? I seem to have forgotten them.
Okay.
Huh? Sit down.
Oh, thanks. You're eating kind of late, aren't you?
All I had for lunch was a strawberry parfait.
Oh, that sounds interesting.
It was more interesting than you think. In fact, I've sort of had a bad day so far.
Why? In what way?
Well, I keep bumping into this good-looking girl all day, and each time I do, Kris shows up.
Oh, well, those things happen. In fact, it happened to me once when your mother and I were first married.
Was she a blonde?
No, she was a redhead. Every time I'd suggest that your mother and I go out someplace, this girl would be there.
Makes it a little difficult, doesn't it?
It sure does.
What happened?
Well, we were at a dance one night, and sure enough, this girl was there. And the next thing I knew, your mother had invited her over to the house.
What was she trying to do, put you on the spot?
No, it was just her way of showing me that she wasn't upset or worried about anything.
Oh.
But I wouldn't worry about Kris. Women have a way of working these things out. She might even wind up inviting this girl over to your house.
Somehow, I don't think that'd be such a good idea.
Would you care for something?
I think I have a chocolate house. No, make that a strawberry parfait. That sounded pretty good.
Good luck, and don't spill any. If it gets on your shirt, it looks like lipstick.
I didn't know it was for dinner. Where? Oh, yeah, I know where it is. In fact, I was just over there today. Yeah, well, I'll leave a note for him. Okay, I'll see you later. Thanks for calling. Bye-bye.
Hello?
Hi, could I speak to Rick Nelson, please? This is Kris.
Oh, hi, Kris. Just a second. Nelson! Rick? I'm sorry, Kris, he's not here.
Oh, well, would you give him a message for me, please?
Okay, I'll wait till I get a pencil. Okay, go ahead.
Would you tell him the sorority's gonna meet at the Colonial Tea Room for dinner? And that I hope he doesn't mind eating at the fraternity house. Have you got that?
Yes, I've got it. Yeah, I'll be sure he gets it. So long.
Hiya, Greg, old pal.
Sorry, I can't help you out. I'm broke, too.
How'd you know what I was gonna ask you?
Are you kidding? The word's gotten around. Say, have you seen Rick? I'll tell you where he is if you'll loan me $5. Have you seen Rick? $2.50? A dollar? Come on, will you? I got a message here for him from Kris. I'll see that he gets it for 50 cents. Okay, forget it. I'll put it on the bulletin board.
Well, why don't you give it to him yourself?
Because I'm going out of town for the weekend. I'm leaving in about 5 minutes.
Okay, I'll give it to him.
Thanks. Hi.
Hi, Greg.
Hiya, dink old pal, old buddy.
You're wasting your time.
Hiya, Willie.
Hi, say, can you lend me a buck?
Oh, for gosh sake. Hiya, fellas.
No.
A nice bunch of fraternity brothers you are. Oh, hiya, Rick.
Hi, Willie.
Oh, I've already asked you, haven't I?
I'm afraid so.
I must say this is a fine situation. A guy can't even borrow a few dollars to help out his poor old sick father.
Oh, is your father sick?
Well, not yet, but he's going to be if I have to borrow any more money from him.
Before he breaks down and starts to cry, why don't we all chip in a buck apiece and get him off our backs?
You know something? I think it's worth it.
Well, thank you very much, fellas. All donations gladly accepted.
Donations? Who said anything about a donation? I want an IOU.
Well, that's no problem. There you are.
What's this?
That's my IOU stamp. It saves me a lot of time and trouble. It's perfectly legal. That's my signature.
It's the first rubber signature I've ever seen.
It gives you a lot of confidence in these pieces of paper, doesn't it?
I'll be glad to notarize it for an extra 50 cents. There you are, Rick. There was something I was supposed to tell you. Oh, well, I'll think of it later. Business before pleasure.
You don't have any amounts on these.
Well, that's okay. Just fill in the amounts yourselves. I trust you.
Hey, a guy could write IOU $10, signed Wally Plumstead.
What difference does it make? You know you're not going to get paid back anyway.
Yeah, that's for sure.
Okay, fellas, that'll be $1 each. Hey, Rick, that sure was a great idea of yours. I sure want to thank you.
That's okay.
Rick... Oh, no, this has nothing to do with money. It just seems to me I had something to tell you.
Well, if you think of it later, let me know.
No, wait a second. It makes me mad. I can't think of what it was.
Well, don't worry about it. It probably wasn't anything important.
Oh, I know what it was. It was a phone message from Kris.
Kris? Well, what's she want?
Well, how do I know? Greg took the message.
Well, where's Greg?
Oh, he went out of town for the weekend. Now, relax, will you? I've got it here someplace.
Never mind. I'll call her.
Oh, wait. I think I put it in my notebook.
That's okay.
No, I'm sure it's here.
No answer. He didn't say what it was, did he?
No, he had it written on a piece of paper, and then he gave it to me.
Well, I hope it wasn't anything important. I'm about 2 steps out of the doghouse as it is.
I just can't figure this out. Greg handed me the note, and I put it in here, and I haven't opened it since. Except when I gave out those IOUs. Holy smokes, that was the paper I tore into pieces.
That's great. So each guy has a piece of the note.
Oh, well, at least we've solved the mystery.
What the heck did I do with that IOU?
Well, I hope you haven't lost it. Remember, no IOU, no money.
Well, I don't care about the money. I'd just like to know what that note said. Oh, here it is.
Oh, good. What's it say?
It says Rick.
Well, at least we know who it's for.
We knew who it was for. I'd like to know what the message was.
Hey, there's Sean. Hey, Sean, have you got that IOU I gave you?
Yeah.
Let me have it, will you?
Where's the money?
Oh, no money. I just want to look at it.
Forget it.
Oh, wait a minute. It's not for me. It's for Rick.
I don't care who it's for. It's going to cost you a dollar.
All I want to know is what it says.
It says IOU $150, signed Wally Plumstead.
$150?
Well, you said to fill in the amounts ourselves.
Well, turn it over. See if it says anything on the other side.
Yeah, it's a message from Kris. It may be important.
Oh, yeah. It does seem to say something back here.
Well, what is it?
Well, originally, I didn't think I stood any chance of getting my money out of this. But now that I find myself dealing with a somewhat more substantial citizen, I'll do you a very special favor.
Come on, will you?
I'm going to give you a $149 discount and turn this over to you for the cost price of $1. Thank you. It's a pleasure to do business with an honest man.
Oh, what's it say?
It says meet at... And it says for dinner.
Meet where?
Well, how should I know? That's all it says here. The only thing you ever have in your notebook is blank paper. Why'd you have to pick the one page with writing on it?
Now, don't be nasty.
Well, maybe Kris is home by now. I think I'll give her another call.
If she is, would you ask her if I can borrow a couple of bucks? I'm still a little short. Never mind. answer, huh?
No. Boy, this is great. I'm supposed to meet her someplace for dinner, and I don't even know where.
Yeah, it is kind of a ticklish situation.
A little more than that. I was the one who invited her out to dinner. Kind of like a peace offering for a little misunderstanding we had.
Does it have anything to do with that lipstick on your collar?
That's not lipstick. That's strawberry parfait. I better track down the rest of this note.
Well, just to show you my heart's in the right place, I'll help you.
You're kidding.
Yeah, I'm kidding.
No, you're not.
Yes, I'm kidding. No, I'm not.
Hey, Dink, you still have that IOU Wally gave you?
Yeah, I think so.
Why?
Well, I'd like to see it.
How come? Okay, I'll give you a dollar for it.
You got a deal.
Thanks.
Here. You're supposed to be out looking for the IOUs.
I was just taking a little break. Gotta recharge the old battery.
Did you have any luck?
Of course. Although I must say it's a new experience for me, chasing people I owe money to.
See the note.
Correction, note. Here it is. It cost me a dollar to get it back. Okay, okay, don't shout.
Kris, boy, I'm really getting nowhere.
Well, at least you know who it's to and who it's from, and that you're going to dinner someplace.
Yeah, and it's getting late. Kris may be waiting for me right now, for all I know. Who else has part of the note?
Well, let's see. How about Kent?
Yeah, do you know where he is?
Sure, he's got a part-time job painting.
Do you know where?
Here, I'll write it down for you. I'll let you have this for a dollar. 50 cents? 25 cents? Okay, okay.
Something. Meet at someplace for dinner. Hope you don't mind. Something, something house. Kris.
Boy, that's not much to go on.
House? Obviously, she wants you to meet her at your house for dinner.
Well, that's silly. I go home anyway. Why would she want to call me and tell me that?
Well, she wants you to meet her somewhere for dinner.
Probably at the Colonial Tea Room.
The Colonial Tea Room?
That's the last place in the world she'd want to go.
Where'd you get a silly idea like that?
That's what it says on the back of my IOU. I think it fits right there.
Hey, that's it. Meet at Colonial Tea Room for dinner. Colonial Tea Room? Well, I wonder why.
Don't ask me. I've never been there.
Well, I guess I better get over there. Colonial Tea Room.
Hey, good luck. Say, how come you have one of my IOUs? You didn't loan me a dollar.
Well, it was kind of a flyer. I bought it from Willie for a dime.
I really don't know. All I know is I'm supposed to meet her here for dinner.
Well, I'm sure she'll be along any minute. How's this table over here?
Oh, yeah, this is fine.
Well, you go ahead and sit down now, and I'll keep an eye out for her. Oh. There, how's that?
Oh, fine, thanks.
Okay.
Hey, Rick.
Hi, Wally.
Am I too late? Has Kris gone?
No, she hasn't even been here yet.
Oh, thank goodness. I found the rest of the note.
Look, don't worry about it. Everything's fine.
Oh, that's what you think. You haven't seen the note.
Well, I've seen enough of it. It says meet at the Colonial Tea Room for dinner. What else do I have to know?
You better take a look at this.
Dear Rick, sorority gonna meet at Colonial Tea Room for dinner. Hope you don't mind eating at the fraternity house.
Oh, great. See what I mean?
I'm not supposed to be down here at all.
No, but Kris and her sorority sisters are.
Yeah, and it'll look like I came down here to meet Pam.
Come on, let's get out of here.
And wait a minute. If I wanted to meet Pam, I'd be crazy to make it here. Especially since I knew Kris was going to show up. That's just plain logic.
What's logic got to do with girls?
Especially wives. Too late.
Hi, Kris.
Hi.
I've got your husband over there in a romantic little booth.
You what?
Yeah, come on, follow me.
Hi.
Hi.
Surprise.
Yeah, it is kind of a surprise.
Happy anniversary.
What?
Happy anniversary.
Happy anniversary to you. Happy anniversary to you. Happy anniversary, Ricky and Kris. Happy anniversary to you.
Yay! I really don't know what's going on.
Happy anniversary.
I know it's not our anniversary.
Sure it is. You mean you've forgotten already?
Forgotten what?
It's the anniversary of our first date.
Oh! Isn't that sweet?
Well, you two have a good time, and we'll leave you with your thoughtful, romantic husband.
I have a large table reserved in the banquet room if you follow me, girls.
That kind of took you by surprise, didn't it?
Yeah, it sure did. The anniversary of our first date?
That's right, exactly 3 years ago today. Don't you remember?
Oh, sure, I remember it very well. We went swimming.
Yeah, that's right.
In the middle of November?
Oh, I brought along my hatchet and chopped a hole in the ice. Keep smiling till we get home.